today we're going to tell you guys about Anti-Corruption Day.
Without further ado, let's get started!
Despite the 2013 anti-corruption law, about half of the respondents believe that most or all police are corrupt, and 40% believe the judiciary is corrupt. But things might be getting better, at least in the eyes of the people. Less than a fourth believe corruption has increased over the last year. In Pakistan, about 3/4 of respondents perceive most or all of the police to be corrupt. Of the people who encounter either the police or the courts, nearly 7 in 10 had to pay a bribe. Thailand has struggled with corruption charges at all levels, even government officials leading the current ruling military junta to tighten the Anti-Corruption Act in 2015, but the Thai people seem optimistic. Vietnam view corruption as endemic of all 16 countries surveyed. People in Vietnam and Malaysia were the most negative about the situation in the country. About 16% felt their government is doing a poor job of combating corruption. In 5 of the 6 public service, school, hospital, IT documents, police, and utility service, more than half the respondents have had to pay a bribe.
Indonesia has Corruption Eradication Commission, abbreviated as KPK, is a government agency established to fight corruption. KPK is formed in 2002. KPK is independent and free from rule in order to do their rule and authority. KPK has responsibility to public and give report periodically to President, DPR and BPK. Law No. 30/2002 on the Corruption Eradication Commission was passed in 2002, providing a legal basis for the establishment of the KPK. Since then, the Commission has engaged in significant work revealing and prosecuting cases of corruption in crucial government bodies, reaching as high as the Supreme Court. The KPK vision is to free Indonesia from corruption. Its duties including investigating and prosecuting corruption cases and monitoring the governance of the state. It has the authority to request meeting and report in the course of its investigation. It can also authorize wiretaps, impose travel ban, request financial information about suspect, freeze financial transaction, and request the existence of other law enforcement agencies. It also has the authority to detain suspect, including well-known figures, and frequently does so. In Indonesia, the corruptor will be sent to jail and give a lot of fine to make them cherry. However, this kind of punishment doesn't affect a lot to the corruptor. Some corruptors still smiling after getting out from the jail instead of feel sorry or ashamed of themselves. PT Pancawira Usaha Jatim dengan kerugian negara mencapai 11 miliar rupiah. Atas kasus ini, Mahkamah Agung menjatuhkan pidana penjara selama 6 tahun dan denda sebesar 200 juta rupiah subsidiar 6 bulan dengan uang pengembalian sebesar 1 miliar rupiah lebih. Sejak putusan MA menjatuhkan hukuman.
What is the punishment for corruption? In Australia, the punishment for corruption varies depending on the crime, the facts of the offending, aggravated circumstance, prior offense, and whether the offender cooperate with the police or plead early. The trial judge can use discretion to determine the appropriate penalty. To do so, the judge will consider the maximum penalty available and precedent penalties set by previous judges for similar crimes. There are a range of corruption offenses in Australia and also multiple internal jurisdictions which have their own laws and penalties for each offense.
Very important that each one join in. Street campaigns and outreach activities were continued on the 9th of December when all the already well-known anti-heroes were addressing the passers-by with a request to literally pick their pockets for bribes. The surprised and even shocked passers-by were then welcomed by a volunteer who offered them a booklet with practical advice on countering corruption in everyday situations. Yet, apart from outreach campaigns, spreading the word in the media, and work with the citizens, there are other components which are crucial for having an effective fight against corruption. During the National Forum My Recipe of Action, which was co-organized by Transparency International Ukraine, UNDP, Matcha Program and the Friedrich Naumann Foundation, a score of best practices and instruments which can assist civic activists in their fight against corruption were presented. At the beginning of the forum, the methodology for conducting anti-corruption civic expert assessments of draft laws and normative acts, which was elaborated with UNDP support, was presented. This methodology is a user-friendly instrument for locating and assessing potential corruption risks in the draft laws and regulations which are promulgated by the executive branch of the government. It is equipped with practical examples and illustrations for the recommendations that it proposes and gives a qualified civic activist a tool to enable seamless preparation of an expert conclusion. It is anything but freezing in Kyiv. We are celebrating the International Anti-Corruption Day. The forum today has gathered over 150 activists from the whole country. Today we studied methodologies for spotting corruption, talking about it loudly, and supporting each other in real attempts to counter it. Why? Because we have to live in this country, since we want a future for ourselves. It is great that we are doing it together. We say, corruption, you must.
Thank you so much for watching our video.
We hope that you guys know how bad was corruption for us.
Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and share to your friends.
Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.